The New Fly Fisher. I'm your host, Bill Spicer. On this week's show, we're in Labrador at Coopers Minipi Camps. And our targeted species for this week, brook trout. And I mean big, bright red brook trout. We're gonna use a variety of techniques to take these fish. So get your notebooks out. It's gonna be a technical one, and we'll be right back. Let him go back to live another day.
And away he goes.
Great fish. Wow.
Oh, baby. Look at that fish.
Stop, wiggle, on the way down.
The New Fly Fisher has been made possible thanks to Newfoundland and Labrador Outfitters Association, Islander Precision Reels, and Orvis Sporting Traditions.
This week, the New Fly Fisher crew are guests of Coopers Minipi Camps, located 70 miles southwest of Goose Bay in the remote wilderness of Labrador. Minipi Camps offer all the comforts of home with great home-cooked meals, comfortable accommodations, and services which include wireless satellite internet connection. The absolute beauty of Labrador will surely take your breath away. Minipi Camps have a reputation for superb brook trout fishing. Brook trout the size of 5 pounds are an average here and not a rarity. I'm here at the end of the season to take these fish in all their brilliant colors. As a brook trout fanatic, I'm extremely excited about this trip. Our guide for today is Kelly Groves, who's been a longtime fixture at Minipi Camps. Kelly's vast experience with brook trout will no doubt help immensely with the success of this trip. The brook trout is a species of fish in the salmon family. In many parts, it's known as a speckled trout or square tail. Though commonly called a trout, the brook trout is actually a char, along with lake trout, bull trout, Dolly Varden, and Arctic char. This fish is normally colored green to brown basic, with distinctive marble patterns on its back. The lower fins are reddish in color with white leading edges. Often the belly, particularly on the males, becomes very bright red or orange when the fish are spawning. We arrived in the afternoon and decided to go out after supper for an evening fish. At this time of year, the brook trout are not in their usual areas in the lake. They're stacking near spawning grounds, getting prepared to reproduce. Our challenge will be finding the fish. One telltale sign you have found fish is to see them porpoise on the surface. Fish on. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Been a while coming. Oh, yeah. Wasn't quite sure when I was bringing it back. I thought I hit a weed patch and all of a sudden it pulled back, so. I haven't had a look at it yet. It's fighting hard. It's got a given good head shakes. Still can't really see it, but okay. Might be a pike.
Running around like a pike.
It's going around like a pike and staying down like a pike. So I'm almost sure I have one. Come on up here, buddy. Let's have a look at you. No, no, I think it's brook trout. I think it's brook trout. It's unusually, he stayed down for an unusual amount of time. That indicates a, oh, it's a decent one too. It indicates a pike generally when they do that.
He got in the weeds too.
Yeah, that's, I thought I hit weeds first and then it started pulling back, so. Oh man, he's staying right down. And he's really giving a good account of himself. I'm having a hard time controlling him, trying to get him over to the net. And there we go. Yes, sir. There we go. Nice little female, about 3 pounds. Very, very nice. And she really gave a good account of herself.
Okay, I'm just sticking this little pin tag right behind the dorsal fin, so it don't stick into the flesh.
The fish didn't struggle at all, so that doesn't hurt it at all, does it?
Not a bit. It just goes, pierces the skin, it's not even into the flesh.
Yes.
And it's number 379.
379.
Yeah, beautiful fish.
Beautiful fish. Beautiful fish.
And she was all ready to go, so it shouldn't take too long before she kicks out. There she
beautiful.
Goes. The best time of year to be here at Minipi Camp. It depends on how you want to fish. If you want dry fly fishing, it could be anywhere from the middle of June up until late in July. Towards the end of the season, we have some really good brook trout fishing too, but the only thing, it gets harder fishing because the fish are more interested in spawning that time of the year, but they have more brilliant colors that time of the year compared to the rest of the season.
At supper that night, I discussed with Kelly my desire to fish for brook trout in the rivers in the area. With the lodge having its own plane, the following morning it was just a 5-minute flight from Anne Marie Lake, where we were staying, to Little Minipi, which has a very nice river flowing from it. Kelly had said the river was fish-filled, and he didn't let me down. There we go. Fish on, yes, sir. Get control of them. Can't see what it is yet. I think it's a brook trout. Feels like a good one too. Feels like a really good one. So I'll get control of them with my line and my reel. It's a brookie, yeah, I can see the color there. Excellent spot. This is called the honey hole for obvious reasons. Oh yeah, look at the size of this one. This is much, much more like a Minipi brook trout. I said to Kelly, I like river fishing. And he says, I got the place for you. And boy, does he ever. See if we can get him out. Not quite yet, he's not quite ready. Okay. Yes, sir. Ha ha. That's a good fish. Now Kelly's just given me this really neat tailing glove. It's nice, soft material. It's not gonna hurt the fish. So when I grab the tail, I got complete control of this fish.
Yeah.
See, I can hold him tight. Now, that's a Minipi brook trout. 3.5, maybe 3, but a nice, nice, nice fish. And what I'm gonna do, good here, Brett? Let him sit there for a minute. I want him to struggle out of my hands. And there he goes. And he's probably gonna sulk right there for a bit. Good fish. Good fish, I love it. Yeah, he's fine. I love this glove. This is a really good idea. I had complete control of that fish, and it's not any effort to get on when I have to do it quickly. Very nice glove, I like that. Fishing in is called the honey hole, and for good reason. The fish here are aggressive for the most part, so an aggressive, fast stripping in of the line was needed. Fish on. Yes, sir.
Might be a better one.
Hey.
You see the color.
Nice, bright colored one. Don't know how big it is yet, but oh yeah, gotta get him controlled again. I gotta try to control my line at the same time, keeping a tight line on the fish. Well, this is a bright red fish. Oh yeah. Carbon copy of the last one, isn't it? Think, yeah, it's bigger. Oh yeah, it looks like it is, yeah. Ah, brook trout, I love brook trout. What a hoot.
Another male.
Another male, bright spawning colors. Wowie. Oh, gotta love brook trout this size. Now this is not big for Minipi. Minipi, you're talking 6-7 pounds would be your big ones. This would be 3 pounds, but a nice 3 pounds. Nicely colored up, whoa, and away he goes. And I got a shower out of it. I love this glove, love it. Yeah, I'll just stick it in my pocket here for a
future references. I won't forget to give it back to you.
Well, I won't let you
we
forget.
We got that on camera. I won't forget to give it back
I
to
won't let you forget.
The flies needed for late season brook trout at Minipi Camps are conehead zuddlers in a variety of colors, leech patterns such as bunny leeches or woolly buggers in black, mouse patterns such as the shaving brush, and don't forget to bring some poppers in various colors.
Got him. Now that is the most exciting part of our sport. A mouse pattern with brook trout. You just can't beat it. Not a very big one, but so visual, just so visual. That's my first cast with the mouse. Oh my goodness. Oh, exciting, exciting, exciting. And we got fish that are rolling all over around this one section of the river. Oh, all right. Oh boy.
Want the net?
No, I think I can handle this one without the net. He's got a mouth full of mouse. Actually, that's a little bigger than I thought he was gonna be.
Female.
This is a female. It doesn't have a hook on the bottom jaw. The mouth is smaller. Male's jaw will go behind the eye. This one's right beside the eye or a little bit ahead of it. But on a mouse. First cast, can't believe it. My goodness. One thing about mouse, the mouse, it's short-lived. They've seen it for now. Let's see what happens. Give it a few more minutes.
We stayed for a time longer catching many more fish. As the evening approached, we decided to stay the night at the lake and return to the same area the next day. The equipment recommended when coming to Labrador are 9-foot medium action number 6 or number 7 rods with large arbor reels with smooth drags. The lines needed are floating lines in sizes to match your reel, intermediate sinking lines, and full sinking lines for when the fish are deep. The next morning, Kelly suggested we head back to the river we were at the previous day, but begin fishing at the intake. He mentioned other guests had had good fishing there in previous days.
Yes, sir. We just got here. We just got here, and Kelly said, why don't you take a few casts right where the boat launch is? And I've got a good one, nice bright red colored brook trout. Good old zuddler again, white zuddler. Man, oh man, this is a good fish. Very nice fish. Oh yeah, look at the size of them. Ha ha, yeah. There's my 5-pounder. All right. My guide isn't even ready yet. I didn't wait
just
till he unloaded
things out of the boat.
This is exciting. Look at the size of this, and look at the color of this fish. I'm sure the camera can pick that up now. Look at it, man, this is a good fish. Yes, sir. Now that is what I call a brook trout. This, well, I think we're going a little, maybe even more than 5 pounds
here. Oh, definitely, more than 5.
More than 5 pounds here. Let's have a look at him. Look at that. Wow, this is a good fish. Got him.
Number 376.
376.
Yeah.
Yeah, isn't that lovely?
That's a beautiful,
just a beautiful fish.
Beautiful male brook trout.
Yeah. Okay, you go ahead and release him there, Kelly. Got him right there anyways.
Okay.
Handle him as little as possible.
Yeah.
Look at that beautiful, beautiful fish. Give us some tips on releasing the fish.
Well, just hold him in your hand and make sure he's ready to go. Just hold him till he's ready to go and he'll let you know when he's ready. And there he goes.
Away he goes. Magnificent fish. And he'll go down there and probably sulk in behind a rock.
Oh, he'll sulk for a little while?
A little while until he regains his strength.
Oh, and definitely.
He'll be fine.
We've been tagging fish here at the Minipi Lodges since about 2000. From what we gather, the fish are moving from lake to lake. We tag a fish in one lake and it's caught in another area in a different lake. Sometimes they've traveled as many as 20 miles between the lakes.
Fish, got it. It disappeared completely. Another good-sized fish. Yeah. I varied my speed that time. I slowed it down just a couple of jerks at a time. And I think it's another brook trout. Feels like it anyways. I can only see a bit of a shadow there right now. Yeah, it's another brook trout. Not as big as the last one, but a good-sized brook trout. Yeah, it's a long fish, this one. Not quite as fat as the other one. Oh, white zuddlers. Now my strategy in this pool is I'll go through the pool with a white zuddler, then I'll head right back up to the top of the pool and switch over to a black zuddler. Give them something different to look at. One thing about brook trout, if you don't get them in the first couple of casts, move to another area, because they've seen the fly and they're bored of it. They won't touch it. Get that, because that knot has me a little worried. Right there. Thank you, sir. Wow. Boy, you know, that's another 5-pound fish. Wow. Look at that fish. That's another 5-pound fish.
Oh, definitely.
It's just, it's different shape than the last one. Not, this one's longer. You say he's an older fish, huh? I'm gonna just let him relax there. And when they struggle like that to get out of your hands, that's when they're ready to go. That was
a nice fish.
That was unreal. Big fish, big fish. Yesterday we had quantities of fish. My biggest fish was about 4 pounds. Today, two fish in a row, over 5 pounds, each one of them. This is fantastic.
The setup that we're using today is simple. It's a clear, intermediate sinking line to 4 feet of 12-pound monofilament leader and then the fly. An alternative setup would be to use a full sinking line to 4 feet of 12-pound monofilament leader and then to the fly. The fishing continued to be absolutely fantastic for the rest of the day. I caught and released many more big fish. We headed back to the main lodge for supper and to plan the next day's strategies.
When the fishing slows down on our lakes, we have the plane here at our disposal, and so you could go to another lake on the same system and fish a river for the day and then return in the evening and try something new the next day.
The next morning, we got back into the airplane for another short trip to the main lake of Minipi. Kelly told us of another river that had produced large fish in the past. After searching for quite a while and deciding that the fish were not yet in this river, we decided to head back to the mouth. As soon as we got there, we observed fish rolling on the surface, and Kelly said, "This is the place."
Fish on, found them. Took us a while to find them, but we found them. Saw two fish rise here, and this looks like a good brookie. Better get him on my reel. Yes, sir. Oh yeah, shaking his head like crazy. We seen two fish rising right here, and we figure that they're stacking up here at the mouth of this river from the lake behind me. And we figured, right, it's nice when you get it on. Oh boy, boy, oh boy, oh boy. Oh yeah, it's a good, oh man, it's a big fish. It's a big fish. Oh yeah. I think we got quite a few fish here. We just stopped. We seen two rise. And so Kelly said, well, I think maybe they're stacking up here. And I says, I agree with you. And here we are. Wowie. Wowie. And he's lightly hooked, so as soon as you can, Kelly,
yeah,
scoop him. Yep. Yes, sir. All right. Wowie, look at that. Look at that. That's a big, big fish. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Look at that. Wow. Oh, one of my best brook trout. One of my best ones. We're gonna tag this one and weigh it, so I'll be able to tell you an exact weight in a second here. So we're gonna put it back in the net. We're gonna put it in the water while Kelly gets ready. And he's gonna tag this fish. Oh, he's been freshly tagged. See behind the dorsal fin there? Now. Oh boy, the water's cold. I'll wait till he kicks and actually swims out of my hand. Come on, buddy. And away he goes. Now that was exciting. I really enjoyed myself. My secret this week was trying different techniques. I took fish on top, I took fish underneath the surface, and I even took fish on a bass popper. The secret to this is being versatile. Presentation is far more important than the choice of fly. Remember that. I'd like to thank Jack Cooper and Minipi Camps for having us here. We had a great time. For more information on today's show and other shows in our series, visit us on the web at thenewflyfisher.com. From all of us here at The New Fly Fisher, thanks for joining us. Tight lines, and we'll see you next week.
The New Fly Fisher has been made possible thanks to Newfoundland and Labrador Outfitters Association, Islander Precision Reels, and Orvis Sporting Traditions.